multi-platinum recording artist, record of the year,
multiple Grammy award-winning singer,
superstar,
number 11, Sealed, and Crazy,
one and only,
the wonderful
Sealed. The song of the year is,
and the winner is,
the record of the year is,
and the winner is, Sealed. Don't know any of the words.
There used to be a da 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 da
da da da da da da da da
da da da
da da
da da da da da da da. But why don't you tell me that over there?
I think I got these scars.
From wolves?
Fucking wolves.
Oh! One name? Who are you, Seal?
The one and only Seal.
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 Seal. Seal. Seal.
Give it up for Seal.
to love, St. Louis, we gotta hold on to love.
This is, just so you know, this is my favorite type of gathering. I'm only going to say it because it's my favorite type of gathering. And it's all like multi-colored, and it's all beautiful, and it's all ages, and it's, you know, this makes me really happy. Anyway, we'll sing a few songs for you tonight. Some of them you'll remember, you know, some of them you won't. Some of them will have memories attached to them, some of them you'll choose to forget. But, well, they're like that, aren't they? Like, songs are like, you know, I take it people have these early albums, and they're like soundtracks to chapters of our lives, aren't they? They're like, you know, and some of those chapters we, you know, might want to forget, and some we remember with great joy. So we'll do our best to take you on that journey this evening, okay? Let's start with this one.
Oh, no. So
take those tears down. Love to see you all right. No, when you take those tears down.
Thank you.
with a laser.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. You ever think about it? You ever think about this journey that we're all on? You ever think about that, like, how long does it last? Like, how long? What is it we're actually doing here? I only ask that because I think about it more often these days. Or I should say there was a phase that where I was thinking about it a lot, and that was about five or six years ago. And a funny thing is I met this incredible guy who said that he asked me if I wanted to do this thing. It was like a quadrant. You know, I guess it was a little kind of, not a test, but an experiment that kind of helps you figure out where you are in your life. And funny thing is, I was just about to go and do some shows. So it was a really odd time for this to happen, but in retrospect, the perfect time. And so he asked me to draw this quadrant on a piece of paper, like the three most amazing things in my life, the three worst memories in my life, three goals that I was trying to obtain. But the most interesting one was the last one. It was the fourth quadrant. And he said, draw a picture of where you see all your life. An odd thing, like draw a picture of your life. So, without thinking about it too much, you know, I did the three things. I did the other quadrants, and that was pretty easy, you know, kids, etc. First time I met Joni Mitchell, stuff like that, you know, great things happen. Divorce, worst thing, you know, stuff like that. Same stuff everyone goes. But the fourth quadrant was really interesting. And he said, draw a picture of your life. And so, without thinking about it, almost subconsciously, I drew this like really spiky, rocky ground, like really, really bumpy. And then it got to a certain stage and went like that. But it didn't keep going. It went and it plateaued right about here. And then I drew a picture of me staring into the distance as a big question mark, big old question mark, and ever so faintly just behind it, I could just about make out an exclamation mark. And I showed it to him and he read it, and I said, well, what does this mean? And he said, well, he said the bumpy bit, you know, all of that, the rocky start, you know, that's obvious. And then that's when your life changed and it took off, so to speak. And he said, but now you're at a plateau and either you could stay, which is fine, or you can see that there's a big old question mark in the distance. And what he was saying was that you have an opportunity now to go and dig, to get the biggest shovel you can find and go dig in the dirt. Ooh, I didn't like the sound of that. Go digging in the dirt, as Peter Gabriel said. Go and dig up old wounds and old traumas and get into those reasons why I'm dysfunctional in certain areas of my life. Go digging in that dirt. Oh, we don't like that because we don't like what we find when we go digging. But that was my choice because he said to me, you know, I can promise you that it's going to be tumultuous. It's going to be tough. You're going to be on the edge. Sometimes you feel like you're just running out of life itself. But keep digging. Keep digging through it because I can assure you that if you can just stay the course and dig through, man, what will happen on the other end is just so magical. And you know what? Standing here at my age, doing the thing that I love to do, seeing your faces, seeing the love, he was right. So, I say that to say this because it was my conclusion and my understanding that although we like to think we're different, and we are to some degree, but at our core, we're all the same. And I know, I share that story with you because I know that each and every one of you here tonight has a version of that story. And to you I say, stay the course. It's worth it. Dig.
Oh.
just don't know what's got into me. First I was blind and I could see.
My baby. Thank you.
I just want to hear that guitar. Isn't that beautiful? Woo! Again. Search for my mother. I come across a reason. Should we start that again? Yeah. Oh, this sounds so good. And if I try to reconcile, yeah, then maybe I would know for how long. This time. Well, here we are in separate from I can hear you sighing, sing. A song to sing. Dry up tears and fly. Still that window. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Once upon a time, I did have a guitar, but I have to tell you, it's completely my fault because I never tell them what I'm doing. Well, actually, I say I'm doing one thing and I have this nasty habit of doing something completely different. But you know, it feels like that kind of rhythm, don't you think? Have you got the wrong guitar? What do you think I was
Bye. Don't forget about the pain.
Thank you. Are you doing okay? How are you doing? You okay? How are you feeling? How are you feeling? How are you feeling after your great performance? That's what I want to know. How are you feeling after your great performance? Yeah, that's how it is. That's how it is. It might be us up there playing and singing. And yeah. But I can assure you we are all performing here tonight. Look at you. It's a beautiful thing, but we'll get back to that. First of all, I want to introduce this incredible group. This is my extended family. So I want to introduce you from out here so I get to see you. I get to see when you're, I get to see what happens when they shine their light on you. On vocals, the beautiful Miss Natalia Hall. I get to clap for you too. On percussion and vocals, the wonderful Mr. Everett Bradley. So this is what you do, this is what it's like for you. Okay. I remember to cheer. Okay. So, on guitar and vocals, Mr. Matt Dozer. All right. And on keys, I've known this guy on keys for 33 years. Oh man, I could tell you some stories about what has happened in those 33 years. But you know, he probably won't turn up to the show in Chicago tomorrow if I do that, so. You know, I gotta keep it relatively respectful. On keys, my brother, Mr. Jamie Mahalberg. And next to him, on drums, I've known him almost as long, 30 years old. Oh, you think I could tell you stories about Jamie and I, but this guy? I mean, things got so risky that he had to move to Berlin. Which is not strange until you consider he's from Austin, Texas. How does that happen? On drums, Mr. Earl Harvin. And I think most of you know who this next gentleman is. Exactly, what did you say?
Great producer.
The great producer, right?
The one,
exactly. So, interesting bit of trivia, did you all know that Video Killed the Radio Star was the first song to be played on MTV?
Yeah!
How did you do that? What did you say? I remember that too. I remember sitting in front of my TV and going, what is that song? And why are MTV playing it? Right? Well, I figured out why they were playing it, but it was just so perfect, and I hadn't heard anything like it. And I thought, God, what it must be like to be able to work with someone who makes music like that. Right? And then I heard like songs like Grace Jones, Slave to the Rhythm. Yeah. And the album Noise, Moments of Love, you remember that? And Owner of the Lonely Heart. Right? I remember to name a few. Do you remember Relax? Frankie Goes to Hollywood? Yeah? So I remember being this young, I don't know how old I was there, but I was aspiring, thinking what it must be like to work with someone like that who makes all of that incredible music, or who produces it, who makes these incredible records that make us dream, make us think it's possible. And what do you know, one day, my dreams came true. I walked into a studio, into a record company in 1989, I think it was, and this man was crazy enough to sign me on bass guitar. My producer, my mentor, my brother, Mr. Trevor. Okay, so I really want, you know what, I really want to stay out here and sing this next song for you before we go home. But I want the people up top to be able to see, and unfortunately, because I wanna connect, you see, because the whole point of this thing, and then we'll get to singing. The whole point of what we do is connection. That's the purpose, all right? The purpose is connection. And when I say connection, I don't necessarily mean us connecting with you. That's nice, and musically we do that, and you're here. So by definition, that is, as long as we don't screw up, that's gonna happen. But when I say connection, what I really mean is connecting with ourselves. See, there is this notion that people like to throw around that, you know, because of all the chaos going on in the world and the news, and there is this notion that we have somehow lost our way and that, oh, we're doing, you know, and oh God, we screwed it all up. Well, I don't necessarily subscribe to that. I think that what it is not so much that we've lost our way, is that sometimes, and I speak for myself here, so I don't want to be too presumptuous, but sometimes I can be a little disconnected. Only this morning I just realized, bitching about something just so ridiculous, right? And I caught myself, right? Because I was being negative. I had a negative face, and I was like, they were talking something which is, and just the tone in my voice was negative, and I caught myself. And I realized that I was disconnected, that it wasn't really me. It wasn't that I all of a sudden turned into some like nasty person. I was just disconnected. Because I believe that when I'm connected to my heart, man, the heart's capable of the most wonderful things. All of that stuff, all of that noise that they talk about is but a distant memory. So our purpose here tonight is to remind us to be connected. That's all, it's that simple. Because I have faith in us. I have faith in us. We are beautiful when we're connected. Now, and then a rainstorm came over me. And I felt my spirit break. I had lost all of my belief, you see. Through a prayer. If I sing love, will you sing love's divine? If I sing love, will you sing love's divine? Woo! I need love,
love's divine.
I need love,
love's divine.
I need thank you.